direct from Studio A of the Howell Cheney Technical High School Media Production Shop. It's HCTV News.
Welcome back to another year at Cheney Tech. I'm Xavier Vasquez.
And I'm Gabby Ruggiero. Another school year means another year of HCTV News.
We look forward to bringing you more stories created by your digital media production shop.
I, for one, had a great summer, but I'm curious, how was yours?
My summer wasn't great. The worst summer of my life, actually. Leave a comment below telling me how your summer was.
Speaking of summer, Comic-Con, the convention for fans of comics and sci-fi, was a popular attraction for many people this summer.
There are a dozen Comic-Cons around the country going on year-round, including here in the Hartford area during August.
Fellow senior Sierra Rosa did a story exploring the Comic-Con phenomenon. Let's check it out.
Comic-Con. The convention was founded in 1970 by three well-known fans of comics, movies, and the science fiction genre. Their group included a bookstore owner, an entrepreneur, and a candy shop owner. They started collecting comics at a very young age and soon fell in love with them. They'd been fan of conventions before, but they decided to start a convention based off of comic books, and it took off. The convention comes to Hartford once a year. This year, there are thousands of happy fans in attendance. According to the official Comic-Con site, there are 63 conventions which cater to fans of comics, TV shows, and movies all over the United States. Comic-Con is a place where people can express themselves by sharing their art, their costumes, also known as cosplay, and their video game skills. Exhibitors broadcast new games and movies and related merchandise. Animators and directors talk to their beloved fans about new episodes, movies, and answer their questions. Comic-Con is a place where fans can gather and socialize while wearing their best costumes and talking about their favorite celebrities and shows. The next Comic-Con is WiredCon on September 24th to 27th, 2015, and will be held in Los Angeles, California.
Well, however you spent your summer, we here at Cheney Digital Media Production hope you fully enjoyed your break from school. Our first project this year for the shop's sophomores, juniors, and seniors was to create a version of a Vine.
Oh yes, the Vine projects. Our Viners are 6, 10, or 15-second looping videos. Each video will loop twice.
The first Vine was made by Sierra Rosa, followed by senior Cameron Lovett and junior Morgan Landry.
Son, where'd you find this? Son, where'd you find this?
Maybe we should get back. Mr. Simon's probably looking for us. Maybe we should get back. Mr. Simon's probably looking for us.
Okay. Wow, those vines were great.
That's right. And they're also viewable on the Cheney Tech Media page on YouTube. Soon after school started, the exploratory fair took place, and was, just as prior years, a great success.
Senior Tristan Spence manned our table and also covered the fair. Here's his report.
I'm here outside the Exploratory Fair at Cheney Tech, where freshmen and parents can come and get a better understanding of our school. They will visit booths and talk to shop representatives. Here, let's go get a better look.
Fair looks great. See all the exploratory kids walking around, checking out all the different shops. We had a lot of parents here this morning that joined us for breakfast and walked around and got to see a little bit more about what the school's all about.
At the Exploratory Fair, shops and clubs are given the opportunity to present their best work to freshmen as well as their parents. Let's go get a closer look at the booths.
We're serving
chicken curry soup
and French gnocchi with roasted tomato sauce. Everything's going good. A lot of people eating our food. A lot of people liking it. Got a lot of mmms, ahs. Everybody's attracted to the sound. I mean, the smell and the sound of the pan.
Yeah, everything's really going real good around here. Everyone's liking the food and it's real going great.
I'm presenting carpentry. We're just showing the freshmen what we do over the years, like what we do for today and how we make our toolboxes and stuff. Sophomore year we make cabinet making, so we do the base cabinet and the wall cabinet. And then for junior and senior year we go out for production and we use these blueprints.
Reporting for HCTV News, I'm Tristan Spence.
Thanks for that great report, Tristan.
The Exploratory Fair isn't the only thing this school has in store for freshmen.
This year, students were given Chromebooks for the classroom and out-of-school purposes. My co-anchor, Xavier, has a story.
At the beginning of the year, freshmen are given a piece of tech that would aid them in both shop and academics. This piece of tech is called a Chromebook. A Chromebook is a laptop out of a different breed. Instead of running Windows or Mac OS, Chromebook runs its own Chrome OS. These machines are designed to be used primarily while connected to the internet, for most applications and documents living in the cloud. So Google automatically provides 100 gigabytes for every single Chromebook. With everything being nearly saved online, you'll be able to access from any other computer. So even if something happens to your Chromebook, you'll still have everything. Why do students need Chromebooks, you may ask? Well, we interviewed Cheney's own librarian, Ms. Martin, who supplies the Chromebooks.
We use Chromebooks because it gives students the opportunity who may or may not have technology at home or have access to technology at home to have access to technology, since we are turning into a very technological, especially in education, community, and society. This year, home office, which is used to be known as central office, filled out a grant to see how the Chromebooks would work, and we're just trying to keep up with the times, you know, central office, and that came from the superintendent of schools and the assistant superintendent of schools and the director and the consultant for technology. They've been working on this for a couple years now, on getting Chromebooks to students. So it wasn't something that happened overnight. It's been in the making for at least maybe 2 or 3 years, and it just again had to come down to, we want to do this for the students. We are Cheney Technical High School. We are technical high schools. And so that's where the decision making came from. It came from home office and the student. A lot of other districts are handing out Chromebooks to their students, and they've been doing it for some time. And so it was our turn to kind of just jump on board. And so more than anything, it was just making sure we had the funds and making sure that the rollout was going to be smooth. And so next year the freshmen will get it, and then the freshmen after that, and then the freshmen after that.
It's great to know about what's going on around the school, but what about here?
What do you mean?
Well, some people might be curious as to what we are doing here in digital media.
You need not worry. We never forget the fans of digital media. All our best content is viewable on the Cheney Tech media page on YouTube, so don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.
Well, let's take a break from our reports for a while and go see some more grapevines.
These are by seniors Dylan Ari, Tristan Spretz, and Brett Gentry.
To Jurassic Park.
My horse is amazing.
sure was fun.
Cheney Tech's annual Halloween party is once again making an appearance. Students will dress up, spend time away from class, dance, and eat yummy treats. However, not just anyone is able to go. In order to participate in the Halloween party, you must pay an admission fee of $3.
Student Council discount members get $2 off and can get into the party for only $1. This year's costumes also have a few rules. Students are required to wear their IDs for classes before the party begins and to enter the party, but of course they are not required to be worn during the party. CTHSS dress code rules do apply, which means you cannot promote drugs, violence, drinking, harassment, or bullying.
Lastly, although it's a given, props cannot present potential safety or health risks to any person or property. If a costume does fit the guidelines, it can be entered in the competition where 3 winners will be selected. Top 3 costumes will win a gift card of $15, $25, $40.
That's not the only way you can win, though. There will also be 2 gift cards given to the 2 winners of the limbo contest. Make sure to respect each other and follow the rules in order to have a fun, safe time at the Halloween party. We'll hope to see you on this Friday the 30th.
If Halloween is in your cup of tea, or you want to be more involved in Cheney, you can look into new clubs.
Our fellow senior Cameron Lovett gathered more information on clubs in our next story. Here's Xavier with the scoop.
Xavier Vasquez here reporting on club days and their return. Here's Ms. Olson and more information.
Club days are coming back. Cheney Tech has a history of having clubs during the school day. It's something that happened maybe about 5 years ago. They stopped doing it, and they're coming back, I think, because a lot of people, teachers, administrators, feel that it's a really positive thing. There's evidence to support that clubs will complement classroom learning. Club days are already scheduled. They're in our year schedule, and they are starting on October 28th. I believe there's 8 scheduled club days through the year, starting in October and going all the way through June. The club days are going to take place from 12 to 2 every time they meet, and they're going to take place in different locations depending on which club you are involved in. It's going to be a wide range of clubs. The one thing that brings all the clubs together is there's going to be a focus on community service and self-help. It's going to range from things like job shadowing, school beautification, you know, like cleaning up the school, work-based learning, Skills USA. I do a club Envirothon, which is going to be involved. If any student has an idea, if a group of students have an idea for what kind of club they'd like to do during club days, please send a suggestion. We're going to set up a suggestion box at the Library Media Center, and if you could just write your suggestion and put it in there. And a good way to get your club started is to find some faculty to advise it for you.
Thanks for the great information on clubs. Don't forget, if you still have any lingering questions to ask Ms. Olson. Have you ever wondered what the hip kids are drinking nowadays?
You mean they're not drinking the same old soda pop we are?
While some are drinking soda, energy drinks have grown more and more popular in recent times. I did a story on it to help explain what the kids are drinking and how it affects them.
Oh, sorry, I didn't see you there.
I was just drinking this Rockstar.
I like Nas better.
Do you know what you're drinking?
Rockstar?
Nas?
But what's in it?
Doesn't matter.
You like Monster?
Mm-hmm. You know, a lot of teens don't know what's in what they drink. Can energy drinks be dangerous?
In America, the top 10 energy drinks of 2014 were, in order, Red Bull, Monster, Rockstar, NOS, AMP, Full Throttle, Zions, Zenergy, Arizona Energy, Rip It, and Venom. Worldwide, the top 5 energy drinks in order are Red Bull, Monster, Rockstar, Lucozade, and Burn. According to CaffeineInformer.com, Monster Energy has a similar marketing plan to that of their biggest rival, Red Bull. They sponsor huge extreme sporting events as well as individuals in each sport. Also, you will see them promoting at music festivals around the world. According to American Association of Poison Control Centers, in 2015 through April 30th, poison centers have received 596 reports of children 18 and younger exposure to energy drinks. Drinking too many energy drinks at one time or drinking one too fast can cause nausea, vomiting, nervousness, tremors, insomnia, restlessness, delirium, sweating, headache, seizures, increased heart rate, kidney problems, altered heart rhythm, mood changes, withdrawal, diarrhea, chest pains, increased blood pressure, and dehydration. These energy drinks also have varying levels of caffeine, some levels quite dangerous. According to CaffeineInformer.com, a regular Dunkin' Donuts coffee has 178 milligrams per 14 fluid ounces. Red Bull contains 80 milligrams per 8.46 fluid ounce can, considered to be a moderate level. Monster, Rockstar, NOS, and Full Throttle all contain 160 milligrams per 16 fluid ounce can, considered to be a very high level. Cocaine contains 280 milligrams per 8.4 fluid ounce can, considered to be an extreme level, nearly four times as much as Monster, Rockstar, NOS, and Full Throttle. Cocaine Energy Drink is an energy drink from Redux Beverages, available in an 8.4 fluid ounce can. The drink claims that it is 350% stronger than a Red Bull. Keep in mind, there's more in energy drinks than just caffeine. Should teens really be drinking this stuff?
While the show is still winding down, we have one more set of vines for you to check out by juniors Kyle Isleb, Mercutio Sanders, Dylan Sharp, and sophomore Egypt Bell Clayton.
Let's watch.
Two, one, go.
Hey.
Fun to watch. You know what else is fun to watch? Cheney Tech sport teams.
Absolutely. In fact, Josue Cardona, who is number 57 on Cheney varsity football team, has a senior preview on the football team.
Our football team is a work in progress. They started off kind of slow. We had a great job at our spring practice, and we did a lot of, summer practice in August, and we did a lot of good things. Our first game, we didn't play as well as we could have. We still got our win. So we're 2-0, but we have a long way to go, and we still have 8 more games. But every day in practice, we seem to be getting better, and teamwork is working out well, and everybody's helping each other out. I'm very proud of the progress we make week by week. But where we are right now is an unfinished product.
I think the team next season is going to be, if they practice and train like they should be during the off season and before they start, it'll be a really good team, and I honestly believe that they might even do better than we did this season.
There's a couple things. I think last year's team had two really great players, and we had more than two players. We had a lot of players that were really good in our program that had been there for 4 years. But they had to go through 3 or 4 different types of offenses and 2 different head coaches. But they had 2 special players that were putting up record numbers. But I think at times, because we had 2 players that were just really good, we kind of relied a lot on them. And at times, I think the rest of the team just kind of stood around, watched our 2 players, Trevon and Sean, do really great things, which was awesome for them. And then we didn't really support them as well. And our team this year is the true meaning of a team. Like, we are, we have, 11 guys on the field, and every one of them is equally as important as everybody else, and they're all working together to achieve one goal. And I think the one thing I really like about our team this year is that we all either succeed or fail together, and I think our team understands that. They really pick each other up when things are going wrong, and they really like to celebrate and have fun when things are going right, which is just a great aspect of a good team. So,
the seniors leaving the team have already made a huge impact on the team, and I think that they really instilled the value of family and, you know, togetherness to the team, and the people left behind really took that in, and they'll be even closer team than we were. So I think that'll help a lot during the season.
Wow, we sure have learned a lot about the new school year and what is important to know going forward.
That's right. Be sure to let us know which vines are your favorites in the comments below.
Thanks for watching this first edition of the HCTV News for the 2015-2016 school year.
See you next time in HCTV News.